Now I want to show what I did at the beginning to make an accurate tools for repairing metal working machines.
3 years ago, I began to prepare for the repair of metal working machines in my workshop. I decided to make the necessary set of tools myself. Accomplishing such a task is an interesting adventure. Now I have already made a very flat surface plate and a very even straight edge, 55 degree straight edge and 90 degree precise angle. But the first thing to do, having nothing straight, these three straight edges. As a result, I got three very even stripes. The indicator is 1 micron. The arrow is motionless. Rear heel of the line. If there is a propeller, the arrow will go to the side. The edges are made from these segments of the I-beam. For installation on a magnet from a grinding machine without bending and twisting like a propeller, legs with the 3 points support are attached to the future straight edge with glue. The legs are glued using a flat surface. Grinding is done using such a machine. Now the surface matches the accuracy of this machine. I will check how flat the surface turned out. Additionally, I will process it with sandpaper. I will take measurements with these calibers in increments of 1/100 of a millimeter. The gaps between all pairs of 3 polished strips were measured one by one. Measurement data is recorded. Since the 3 rulers were ground on the same machine and under the same conditions, their geometry turned out to be similar. Here is a model of the state of the surface of the rulers. Hollow in the middle, 17 microns. I will fix this gap. This time I prefer to remove the steel with a rubber abrasive tool. This was done for several hours, but as a result, the gap between the rulers became the same size, about plus or minus 5 microns. Now the probe thinner, then the support probes at 10 microns and passes through the entire gap with the same resistance. At this stage I do not perform Bessel points. Next I applied the lapping paste. It is a fine and soft abrasive. The surface that is mutually in contact becomes a dark matte color. Now you can clearly see the state of the surfaces of the rulers. On all rulers, the correct exact plane was created, but visible small hollows in some places. I also want to show an interesting test. A thin layer of dry black pigment powder mixed with oil is applied. The image of the planes of the rulers indicates a close mutual fit. I used a soft medium size abrasive. Since there are small depressions on the surfaces, I will do some more lapping. This must be done long and slowly. Now measurements can be taken in blocks with a step of 1 micron. It is necessary to press it more tightly. A speck of dust prevents it. Thicker by a micron and test tight. Thinner by a micron and test freely. All combinations in all places have been tested. But such a test is much more interesting. the lower ruler is held only by atmospheric pressure.
Thank you. Goodbye.